while you're here. Give him a big loud scream. So, I'm just gonna go down the list of names and we're gonna bring them up on stage, and I want you to be loud and appreciative for every single one of these actors. At the top of my list, I have Mr. Christopher Sabat.
Doing this, you would dub a show, and what maybe you're like, when's this thing gonna be they're working on now. They're like, oh yeah, this show, the first episode is on next week. And you can just see the instant feedback that people have watching it. And that's been the biggest change. And so I know I can speak for all of us that we knew this was going to be a really successful show. We knew that a lot of people loved it. So the pressure has definitely been on all of us to make sure we do the best possible job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with that. That's a good answer.
I'm not going to really waste a lot of time. I know there's a lot of people here with a lot of questions. Are you guys okay with answering questions?
Yeah, please.
All right. So, we got a mic here. I got a line of people here. So please go ahead and approach the mic and ask your question.
Hi.
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 I'd just like to thank you. I have a son that's autistic, and for a kid who did not take social cues, vocal cues, emote, we started watching anime just 2 years ago, and he's a totally different kid now. He emotes, takes the social and vocal cues that you guys put down. So thank you from the bottom of my heart as a mother. Thank you for changing my kid's life.
Awesome.
The only time I ever get to play a bear was Sands of Destruction, Kuma, and I love that role, and I wish more people watched Sands of Destruction.
You know the Pito Bear?
I'm in a show called Riddle Story of Devil, which is perfect, but it really does. And I wish more people knew about that one, because it's a lot of fun.
Awesome. I did a trilogy of films called Appleseed Ex Machina, and Appleseed Alpha. I just really dug that character, and I don't always see it, but yeah, that's one I would think of. I would say Eden of the East.
Yeah. Yeah. I said it.
Rage of Bahamut Genesis.
Bye.
Stein's what? Stein's gate? Stein's
this one's being even more popular.
Princess Jellyfish would be another one.
Okay, I think that's everyone. Thank you guys so much. You guys are all awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sabat, did you answer?
No, I didn't, but there's so many answers, and they're all good ones. Sergeant Frog was
yeah.
the one.
So many voice actors in one awesome panel, so thank you for coming. So my question is for everyone, I'll make it quick. Aside from the characters you voice as, if you had your own personal quirk, what would it be?
I would be able to transform myself at any given moment into Christopher Sabat.
This a lot of thought. I would like the ability to mentally slap people in the back of the head, and they would instantly know why they were slapped, and they would correct their behavior. And I would save the universe just by driving around town.
And then I would just feed the world, and I would also be very fat and happy.
Yes. Amen!
What about you, David?
I just want to be able to match clothes with Rob McCollum. Yes.
Are you guys matching again?
No.
Oh.
He's matching with Jason Douglas today.
We all came to breakfast, and then we had to all go back to our rooms and change.
Thank you.
similar to the joy of hearing you ask that question.
Yes, like.
It's a magical feeling.
Yeah.
It was a weird feeling.
Yeah.
It was very strange. I think that for me it was weird because I realized that the voice I hear in my head is not the voice that you guys hear. The voice I have in my head sounds a lot like Colleen Clinton.
Parts scary, but also very thrilling. Which you would expect it to be. Like a roller coaster.
I'll just go ahead and say it changed a long time, especially like Chris and some of the people that have been doing it since we were wee things. Chris started when he was 4 years old, by the way.
Exact same voice.
Exact same voice he has now.
That's true.
But it was all DVD and straight to DVD, and then it was like 6 months later, and then it was the only, and even if you rented it or watching it in your house, that was like a solo experience. And then when Cartoon Network came along, all of a sudden, like, oh wait, this is on broadcast television. There are tens of thousands of people watching this at the exact same time as I am. That was a completely different experience because it made it very communal. And oftentimes communal experiences are not as much fun as you think they are, but in this circumstance, it was very fun.
Yeah, I'm of the same, I'm sorry, go ahead. I'm of the same, you know, for so long, it was straight to DVD stuff, you know, you record a season at a time, and so it didn't ever, I never thought that that would be the reality. So, it's kind of a, you know, obvious statement, but it was really, really cool to see it for the first time. I think the other thing that came to mind for me was, you know, when I first started going to conventions, you just never really realized how some of your work might impact other people in a positive way, and that's been some of the most rewarding stuff for me. So when it is getting seen by a wider audience, it's just, it's really cool to be a part of that and hopefully impact people that way. I also have the experience where I'm just like, whenever I watch scenes that I'm in or whatever, I kind of go, oh, I wish I could have done this like this. So I have that choice.
Yeah, no, I get that too.
Yeah, I have a hard time watching my own stuff on television. I'm super critical even when I'm hearing it back. I'm like, oh, I could have done that so differently. It changes though when you have adorable kids of your own and you can have them watch a show with you and then you just feel like with this immense pride for doing something that they can actually see on television.
Although my son really does not care at all. He's totally nonplussed. I try to get him to watch stuff. He's like, yeah, whatever. Everybody's problem does this.
My daughter could care less, but my grandson, he's over the moon about it. So he's always asking me to do Krillin's voice, and he's always asking, who would win in a fight? It's like a panel all day long.
Thank you for your question.
That's a very good question.
Thank you. Come on, man.
I should also note that my daughter has never actually watched Dragon Ball Z. Only seen like one episode of it, but I told her that Vegeta is a prince, and so she thinks that he's like a Disney prince. So she has like Vegeta on her backpack, but she has no idea what a terrifying person he actually is.
I struggle with depression going on 3 years now, and I also suffer from anxiety and kind of talk. But your guys' work actually helped me a lot, especially during my darkest moments. So I just want to say thank you for that before I say anything else.
Thank you.
You're welcome, but pulling yourself out of it, that was all you, girl.
Have a lot of roles that you've done in the past. Are there any retired roles that you wish you could go back to and relive all over again? And then I also have a request. Can you guys do the space duck voice? Like, can any of you do it? I'm really curious.
Space duck.
Yeah, from Dragon Ball.
Oh, there we go. Yes.
I refuse to do that. Space duck. On the grounds it might incriminate me and break contracts violations. But I think he's majestic, and I have a t-shirt that says, so.
Okay. The first part was, guys have a favorite role that you wish you could reprise?
I do. I want to reprise Yato from Noragami.
Called you short. I didn't! Like, that's not
asked a Class 1A were to have lightsabers, if they were in the Star Wars universe, what do you think their lightsaber colors would be?
Pink.
I'd have the entire rainbow.
Becoming a murderer, he would just become a political activist. And then he would just secretly steal certain politicians' blood and cause them to shut the heck up when they step to a microphone. I'm not saying which.
Okay, I have to tell you all something. Oh, this is fun.
ever wanted to live before, and it's been like 30 years. My parents actually make Endeavor look like All Might. I'm just saying. I've tried 20 times to end it all. The only reason why I kept going was because of anime. But I can officially say that I want to live because of all the hard work that My Hero Academia is like. I can do this. That's fine. You guys did such a great job.
Can you come around here? We can see you a hug. Jaime, Caitlin, and Christopher, I was wondering, what were some of your favorite things about playing Kana, Evergreen, and Elfman?
All my research into drinking. My favorite thing about playing Evergreen is Elfman.
That's weird, because literally going to see my favorite thing about Elfman is Evergreen. Like, the scenes that they have together.
Person who had one for all.
Before. The sixth user of One For All. She's asking if they were ever going to go into that person's family or backstory. We don't. Is that correct? Is that what you're asking?
That's correct. Okay.
Good question.
Nice, that is.
Unfortunately, the person who would know that is Colleen Klinkenbeard, and she's at Crunchyroll.
Hey, Colleen, what?
Generally a pretty quiet person, so no, I don't relate to
that. Don't shake your head, honey.
My character is super punk rock, and I actually had a punk rock band when I was in high school. I say that I relate to Sue when I'm sick, because then I end up sounding like this naturally. But I'm not big on flying.
I would say I relate to Dobby in traffic, primarily.
Well, as you can see, I am clearly half bird, half man. So, I have a lot in common with Dobby.
Like Mount Lady, I also have a very large butt.
I don't actually want to kill people, but as someone who often spills things, I do relate to Sting.
I can definitely relate to Todoroki, just in kind of in his demeanor and the kind of.
Because
you're
so cool.
My natural coolness is just
attractive. Yeah. So attractive.
What's that?
Very attractive too.
Yeah.
So see, right?
I wanted to say all that you guys just said, but I knew I couldn't, so I thank you guys for saying that for me.
You're totally welcome.
I had a question. Trina, are you still in that band?
I love you guys. Ever since I was a kid, I've always been watching like Funimation shows.
Thank you.
Overall, you guys have been like part of my childhood. You're the reason why I was able to like make friends, like talk to people. I did not talk at all when I was a kid. Like surprisingly. So it gives me a great pleasure and honor to be able to meet all of you here. To be honest, it was my dream for you guys to have to become the SacAnime. Alright, so my question is, My Hero Academia is a series that fills me with great hope, and like it inspires me, and for a long time now I've been lethargic, like not really wanting to do like the things I loved. But it was My Hero, the first two episodes would fill me with hope and like desire to like, push forward and have like feel like really good. So I was wondering, a general question, what was your like favorite moment that made you like hit you in the heart with feels or like gave you great hope? In the shower, yes.
What's your favorite
those episodes as a director because I felt like at Funimation, we have a lot going on all the time. We have 9 studios running day and night, and I feel like all my friends are in the building, but I don't really get to see them unless they come by my room. So working on that episode, it was like a just kind of like a party, like get all of us in the room together, so to speak, and it was cool. So this was my favorite episode.
All the ones that I'm in.
When I totally carried the team on my back.
I like the stain fight episode, and I also like the Deku Todoroki fight. I thought a lot of, yeah, it was. We wanted to do that one. Was one that we felt a lot of pressure with, to, you know, make sure and nail it. And I was pretty proud of it. So.
What's your name, Pinpa?
Nico.
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 I'm with you. I like all of them. Cause you're smart.
I liked it when I lit up that forest all pretty with blue flames.
Aizawa says, or something about, it's not that the Class 1A, or maybe, I don't know if All Might says it, not that Class 1A is necessarily, you know, better than everybody else, but they learned, because of their experience in a real fight against villains, they've learned not to hesitate. And I thought that was just a really cool line, like, in the face of fear, they learned to act. And, I don't know, that stuck out with me, so that's another one that what you said, Josh, reminded me of.
Yeah,
they know.
Thank you for your question.
Good question.
We have time for pretty much one last question.
I know this guy.
There's two more. Speak round. Nice. Speak round.
Thank you so much for being here. You're a hero to everyone. So thank you. So my question was how difficult was it to do the simulcast? Japanese and English, and what made it so difficult?
We have no time.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So there's always a little trepidation there, like, you know, are we coming at something too soon, or character development-wise, we want to make sure and just tread that lightly, because you don't know what's really going to happen.
Yeah, you have to record if you're sick, or if you are out of town, you have to make your way back into town, or try to. It becomes a huge challenge, but with it comes some, like, excitement.
Yeah, before we had those, I mean, we generally put out an episode a week. Now we have to put out an episode a week. That's a big difference. Having to have to do it, it means you have to be on your toes and agree all the time.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi. I was going to ask you, what would you say your character's theme song would be? That's a song that's not for a My Hero. So, like, what would the theme song be?
Rolling Stones, Paint It Black.
Yeah!
It's not easy being green.
Paint
is my favorite color.
Me and my shadow.
Ring of Fire, Johnny Cash.
She's 19.
Oh, wow.
She's 19.
this panel is folding pretty quickly. I think this is an end scene, I think, guys. Don't you think?
Thank you, guys.
We want to thank everybody for being here. Thank you for being in our show. This was amazing. You guys have a good time? Thank you, everybody. Have a good afternoon. If you guys have questions or other concerns, you can always see the guests at their signings later on today.